Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be practicing our algorithm solving skills, our thinking out loud skills, our math skills even. This is a good practice problem not because it's something that you'd necessarily encounter in the real world, although you might, but I picked it because it's complex enough that you have to plug in and really wrestle with it for it to make sense, but not so complex that you need some very specific domain knowledge like math or computer science to really get it. And I'll give you the disclaimer up front that the solution we're ending on is not necessarily the fastest solution, nor does it solve for various edge cases like inputting negative numbers or inputting numbers in any order or so on. I'll leave you to do that on your own if that's something that you want to challenge yourself with. So today we're talking about the greatest common divisor of two numbers. What is the greatest common divisor of two numbers, or GCD, which is what we're going to call it right now. So the GCD is the largest number where you could divide two other numbers by that first number that we talked about, that GCD, and have no remainder. So to be more specific, our example will be to find the GCD of 132 and 77. And the answer will be 11 because of the fact that no number larger than 11 can be evenly divided for those two inputs, that 132 and 77. There's a lot to dive into here, and there are a couple of different ways that it could possibly be solved. But for our jumping off point, we're going to be using an insight from something called Euclid's algorithm, which tells us that the GCD of two numbers is also a factor of the difference between those two numbers. So looking at our example from before, the difference between 132 and 77 is 55, and thus our GCD is going to be somewhere available to that 55 as well. So if we do that math again, but using the smaller number and the remainder, in this case 77 and 55, what do we get as our remainder? It's 22. And what if we do that again with the old smaller number and the remainder, 55 and 22? We get 11. And then if we do that even one more time with 22 and 11 divided by 11, our remainder is 0. And so there's nowhere else to go. And thus 11 is our answer. So does that make sense? I think When I was writing the script for this video, I was having a hard time visualizing it, and so I wanted to write out all those equations for you here so you could sort of see it more visually. But for me, the hardest part was accepting, or I should say even understanding, the premise in the beginning that the GCD of two numbers will also be in their difference. And then once you go from there and actually start writing the numbers, it works out. And the other kind of jump in train of thought was going from using difference to remainder from dividing, aka this modulo that we're working with here. This is an all right leap to make in this context, in the way, because if you think about what modulo is in the way that we're using it, it's the difference of the remainder of two numbers after effectively subtracting the smaller number multiple times. It's the difference or the remainder of two numbers after effectively subtracting the smaller number multiple times. I've been referring to difference and modulo interchangeably as a result, which in most cases isn't true, but in the way we are doing it, it does work out. So let's do some pseudocoding and get some code on the screen. So our inputs are two integers and the output is one integer, specifically the largest number that both are divisible by. We're looking at differences and iterating to smaller and smaller numbers. So we'll say as long as the smaller number is greater than zero, continue iterating on what we're about to do next. So what is that iteration? How does this iteration happen? One iteration itself is storing the smaller number in a placeholder variable called temp, then finding the modulo of the larger and smaller numbers and reassigning the smaller number as such. Then finally reassigning the larger number as the temp value, which is the old small number, and continuing. So you can sort of see this is our original large number, this is our original small number. The original small number becomes the next iteration's large number, and so on and so on and so on. And our first remainder becomes the next iteration smaller number. Then that remainder becomes the next iteration smaller number. Then that remainder becomes the next iteration smaller number, and so on. So that's how each subsequent iteration is populated from the old one. Now, when we get to the end, quote unquote, of any possible iterating that we could do, because as you can imagine, we can't be doing a modulo that's dividing by zero, right? So by the end, we're going to have a larger number that's our answer and a smaller number that's zero, which will break the loop. So spoiler alert, we're going to be doing a while loop. And the condition is as long as the smaller number is greater than zero. So in this case, it would not be, because it'll get reassigned to zero, but then it'll stop because you can't divide by zero. Return the larger number as it is our GCD for the two original numbers. We've done a lot of talking, and I think that we were kind of all over the place, but hopefully that made sense. And I think that instead of going and writing the code line by line, I will just show you my final result. Putting that pseudocode into practice, here's the result. So we have our loop, and then we have our larger number that's getting returned. So while the smaller number is greater than zero, and then the kind of the meat of the algorithm is this, what is the one iteration, or what does one iteration entail? So we set temp as the smaller number, we reassign smaller number to be the remainder, and then we reset the larger number to be the old smaller number. Now at some point, smaller number is going to be reassigned as zero when we get to this fourth iteration, and that will break out of this loop, and it will be returning the larger number. So let's see what this gives us, and see if it gives us what we want. That we do. So, greatest common divisor of 132 and 77 is 11. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you all in the next one.